Hey, what's going on, everybody? It's your bro here. And in this video, I'm going to teach you guys how you can add videos to your web pages using HTML. Let's get into it. Before we begin, you're going to want to download a video, or you can find one on your computer that you want to use and place it within the same folder that contains the HTML document that you plan on working with. Before I forget, here are the file types that HTML5 currently supports: MP4, WebM, and OGG. If you don't have a video to use, I would recommend looking on your Facebook, your Twitter, your Instagram. You've probably posted a video at some point in your lifetime, and you can always download those too. So if you have a video picked out, place it within the same folder that contains your HTML document that you plan on working with. The video that I'm going to be using is that I was in Tokyo, Japan some time ago, and there were some people go-karting on the streets, and they were dressed as characters from Mario Kart 64. So this is the video I'll be using. I'll be honest, I was geeking out when I saw that, because I'm a huge Nintendo nerd. If you have a video picked out, then we're ready to begin. Now we need to create a pair of audio tags between the body tags of our HTML document. So we're going to say video, and then we need a closing video tag. If you watched the last video on audio, it's going to be a very similar process. So what we're going to do in the opening video tag is type in the word controls. Let's see what we have so far. I'm going to save and reload. Now we have the controls for a video, but this isn't linked to any video, so we'll need to do that. So between the video tags, we need to create a source tag, and within the source tag, we're going to type src equals double quotes, and within the double quotes, we're going to type the video file that we want to add to the video controls. And the video that I picked was called go_karts.mp4. So let's save this and reload. All right, here's that video. However, it's massive. And we know it's working. We can actually go to the opening video tag and we can use the height and the width attribute to change the dimensions of this video. And I'm just going to make up something. We'll say height equals, let's say 250, and width equals 250. Let's save this, reload the page. All right. Here's the video. It's a lot smaller. However, we have all this blank space underneath the video, so the dimensions aren't exact. With how we currently have the height and width attributes set up, these are measured in pixels. And if we were to change one of these attributes, let's say that we change width to 650. Let's save this and reload. Now we have all this white space on the left-hand side, as well as the right-hand side of our video. And if we want to get rid of that white space, we need to make sure that we're increasing our height by a proportionate amount depending on what our ratio is for this video. But you can see that this would be somewhat annoying. So another option, instead of using pixels for our width, we can also give a percentage. Let's say that we want to have the width of our video take up the entire screen. Well, we can say 100%. So let's save this and reload. That's a little bit better. But let's eliminate the height now. So we'll just say width 100. These dimensions seem a lot better. There's no white space within that video player, and the ratio is exactly what it needs to be for the best quality. And with this width attribute, since we gave a percentage, this actually makes our video dynamic in case we resize our web browser. Here's an example. And you can also change the percentage. If we were to place 50 here instead of 100%, this video will take up 50% of the width available to it within the web browser. And like I said before, that's also dynamic. So feel free to adjust the height and the width attributes of your video depending on what you need for your website. At this point, I'll be covering a few keywords that you might be interested in adding to the opening video tag. So if you add the loop attribute, this video will loop continuously. So I'm just going to mute it because it can get kind of annoying after a while. But you can see that it just keeps on restarting over. You can also have a video be muted by default. Just add the muted keyword. And let's reload this. All right, so when we hit play, you can see that the volume is off, it is muted, and we can turn this back on. Lastly, we will be discussing the autoplay attribute. So to add autoplay to a video, type in autoplay within the opening video tag. And just so you're aware, this might not work on all web browsers, and it doesn't work on mobile devices from what I've read. Now, just make sure this autoplay attribute is added to the opening video tag if you want this video to start automatically when somebody visits your page. And you can see that every time I refresh this page, the video just starts over again. And one thing to make sure of is that if you have a video with autoplay, just as a common courtesy, you'll want to be sure to make this video muted, because if somebody visits your website and you have the video play automatically, you'll want to be sure that it's playing without sound, because the user might be in a place that's private or quiet, and you don't want this video blasting sound as soon as they visit your webpage. So if you use the autoplay attribute, just make sure you also make it muted as a common courtesy. Oh, and one cool thing you can do, if you want some sort of background video that the user can't interact with, one thing you can do is take out the controls. So let's see what this does. So we'll save, refresh, and we can no longer interact with this video. So this might have some uses too. Well, that will conclude this topic. I will post the code that I have in the comments down below and pin it to the top if you would like a copy for yourself. But yeah, that is how to include a video on a web page using HTML. Hey you, if you enjoyed this lesson, then you can help me help you in 3 easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.